Hey folks, Adam here. Thought I'd repost this Dreamcast video. I was going through some of my videos and I talked about how I pulled my Dreamcast collection video down and how I might reshoot it. And of course I'm too lazy to reshoot the thing. Well, not to the degree that I went to with this. So I think really maybe there's a half dozen games or so more since this video that I've collected. I really went hog wild on the Dreamcast because it's kind of what drew me back in to collecting probably 4 or 5 years ago. And so I couldn't get enough of it. I bought pretty much everything I wanted for it. Some random titles here and there. If I see them and they're reasonably priced, I'll pick them up. But pretty much I just I have what I have. I think I have what I have. I think maybe the PAL import of Rez and the Shenmue 2 Japanese import and a couple of those might not be in this video, but for the most part it's still pretty current, which it sounds kind of funny considering I probably shot it 2-3 years ago, but I just haven't collected that much for it since that time. So I thought I'd repost it. It used to be in 3 parts, so I'm kind of going to part it together into one video, and we'll just see. I might rewatch. I didn't rewatch the whole thing, but I rewatched a little bit of it, and that's another thing I noticed on my videos, because I was talking in my last video about how I just didn't know what to do or whatever, and it just seemed like I used to have a lot more either enthusiasm or I don't know, energy. I don't think it's energy. I think it's enthusiasm for the collecting and stuff. But it was because I watched this one video and I was like talking about I think I'm gonna maybe post a share the video again or something. But it was about a question from a buddy Mitch up in Minnesota had asked. What's your biggest yes moment when you went out in public and found something? And you're like, yeah, you know, I can't believe I found this. And I was just watching that video and stuff, and it just seemed like I put a lot more enthusiasm into it. And I don't know, the quality of the video, the way that I could tell the time that I put into it was just, I don't know, more than I do now. I mean, basically I shoot something in the car now and friggin' put it into video editor on YouTube and there you go. So anyway, I'll let you get to this Dreamcast video and we'll see you next video. We'll see what goes down in this town. So anyway, here's the Dreamcast video. Thanks for watching, folks. Let's start with the games. Let's get rid of the unpleasantness first. The unpleasantness to me is the sports games. I'm not a huge sports game guy. I'd have to say a good 2/3 to 3/4 of these I actually found at either the thrift store or the pawn shop, and they were really cheap, like a couple bucks or a dollar in most cases. Some of the more unique titles and stuff I picked up at Vintage Stock, and I probably paid too much for them at the time, but to tell you the truth, I don't remember what I paid. So anyway, I think I got a pretty good collection minus a couple pieces that I want to pick up, and we'll get to those as we go. So first off, let's get started. First game here, we got NFL 2K. Now, I've had this game twice. The first time I got it, I got it at a pawn shop, and it had the book had been watered, you know, water damaged, and it was the pages were stuck together. And I found another copy at the thrift store, and it is brand new looking. And I went ahead and picked it up. Not because I'm a huge football fan, but
you know, when it's a dollar or whatever, it's in good shape and it's a place for that system. Why not pick it up? So there's number one. And number two is a similar along the same lines, and I think it was the same situation. NFL 2K1 is the same game. It's complete. It's not the same game. Same game, you know, line, the 2K series. And it's in awesome shape, too. I think this was also a case where the book was water damaged, and I found both of these at one store, and then later on found them again, both together, at a different store. So that's number two. Now, these are sports games. These won't get a lot of play in my system, but, you know, they do fill out a collection rather nicely sometimes. The third game is Virtua Tennis, and it's complete. And the disc is in pretty good shape. Some of these cases have a little bit of cracking to them, but this one especially, but I think this was a pot and shop dollar special. But it's not too bad. If it was too bad, I'd replace the case. That's number three. This one looks brand new, and I know I got it at the thrift store along with the one I'm going to show you after this. That's NHL 2K. These were like a dollar, folks, and it's, you know, brand new. Looks like a hockey puck. The other one looked like a tennis ball, and it pretty much looks brand new. I like hockey games okay. I usually like hockey and basketball a little better than baseball and football when I'm playing them. This was the other one that I know I picked up at the same time. That's NBA 2K, and it's complete. Got a little ridge inside. I think this one might have still had the shrink wrap on it when I bought it, because the disc looks brand new. Come to think of it, I think it did have the shrink wrap on it. I'm not sure who this guy is on the front. If anybody knows, he's playing for the Sixers. I don't know who he is. I haven't followed basketball real close in a while, so. Next one. Yeah, how many was that? Five? Six? Tee off? It's a golf game. Now, golf games, I do take exception. I will play a golf game any day of the week. Tee off is complete. This disc is pretty scratched. I mean, I think it plays, but it's definitely got a lot of surface scratching on it. I could take it over and have them resurface it at vintage stock. But I think I only paid a dollar for it, so I'm not real worried about it. This is one of those where the characters have, like, the big heads and stuff. They kind of look more like, you know, Wii Avatar characters, you know, things like that. But it was like a buck. It's complete, though. I'm going to quickly lose track here, folks. That was number six. Number seven, I thought this would be more fun than it is, because I do like racing games in this style, but it's Suzuki All-Star Extreme Racing. It's a motorcycle racing game. I thought this was going to be more fun than it was, and that's mainly because I like the Road Rash series. I like to be able to bash people with chains and kick them off and stuff. And this was more like a straight razor game, and it wasn't my cup of tea. I prefer, like, a Road Rash, but a couple bucks, I guess. I don't even know what I paid, like I said. That's number seven. I'm going to forget every time. Here's another racer, Tokyo Extreme Racer. I'm pretty sure I got this at the pawn shop where they used to have all their games were a dollar. They don't have as many retro games as they used to when I started collecting seriously again a while back. And come to think of it, the Dreamcast is what kind of got me started into retro collecting again. I didn't really think much about retro collecting up until probably about 3 years ago. And the thing was is I bought for the PS2. That was the console I had at the time. I know that you know, the 360 was out and the PS3 was coming out, but it was a little too expensive for me. And I wasn't going to go there, so I was still buying for the PS2 and stuff. I went to the pawn shop, and behind the counter, they had a complete Dreamcast system with two controllers and two VMU units, and they wanted like $30 for it, I think. And what sealed the deal is I went over to their case and was looking at their games. I was looking at Nintendo games, 8-bit, and they had some Sega Dreamcast. I almost said Sega CD. Dreamcast games. They had a Sonic Sonic Adventure 1 and Rayman, I think, and I've got those in this stack for $1 a piece. And I was like, you know what? I never had a Dreamcast. I'm gonna get this. I'm gonna buy this system for $30 at the pawn shop. Get these games. I'd heard Sonic Adventure was pretty good. And check it out. And sure as hell, I bought it, brought it home, and I started having fun with it immediately. And I had to rush over to the game exchange and look around, because at that time I didn't even really know about vintage stock, and they were fairly new to the area. They built like 3 of them in the last 3 years, but there was only like one or two of them around at that time. There was one in Liberty and one in Independence, I think. I know the Lee Summit and Blue Springs ones have been built since I started going. I'm pretty sure the Belton one has, and I don't know about the Kansas side. So I didn't even know about it. I was at Game Exchange looking around. I was going to the other pawn shops looking for games, and the thrift stores. And my cousin told me about Vintage Stock and took me over there. And when I saw how many games they had for the Dreamcast and stuff, I was like, every week I was over there buying multiple Dreamcast games just to fill out my collection and look at all the stuff that I had missed. Even at that, you know, I mean, like I said, I was picking up a few random PS2 games and maybe looking at their 8-bit Nintendo games and picking up some here and there that I was missing out of my collection, because that was the main thing that I had from when I was a kid that I had a pretty decent-sized collection of. And the Dreamcast really turned me on to buying some of these older systems, like the 3DO, buying the GameCube, and the Nintendo 64, some of these systems that I skipped on, and really brought me back around to collecting for them. So the Dreamcast is probably why I'm doing the YouTube channel, to be honest, because if I wouldn't have got back into retro collecting, I probably wouldn't be doing a channel. So you can attribute all this rambling and bullshit to the Dreamcast. So thank you, Dreamcast. I know I stopped showing games. Hold on. Let's get back into it. Flag to Flag. You might have remembered some of these from videos past as we've gone along. This is a open wheel racing, kind of a, you know, Formula One racing, I think, game. I haven't even played it, to be honest. I don't even think I've played most of these sports titles other than stuck them in to see if they worked. So That's the beginning of what we're going through here. So now it's time to get to what I consider the better stuff. And we'll get rolling. There are some games that I would like to pick up still for the Dreamcast, so this is not exclusive. You know, this isn't my... I'm not done picking them up, but we got Sonic Shuffle. This was one of those that I got a few weeks back when my buddy Ben brought in the box Dreamcast that somebody gave him to give to me because they didn't think it worked. And it's complete and it's in good shape. I don't think I need to pull the discs out and show you the backs because they all work. So, I mean, you don't really need to see a shiny back of every disc. Or scratch back. So that was Sonic Shuffle. The next one we have is Tomb Raider Last Revelation. There's another Tomb Raider game that also came out on the Dreamcast. I can't remember which one that was, but I want to pick it up as well. Just to have a more complete Tomb Raider collection. I have Tomb Raider 1, 2, and 3 on the PS1. And then this last revelation, I can't think of the other one that was on the Dreamcast. But it's complete. The next one, I don't know. I don't think I beat this, but I think I got to the end guy. I think I'm sitting at the end guy and I haven't beat it. But that would be Spider-Man for the... And this Spider-Man is actually... It was weird to play it because when you play Spider-Man 1 for the PS2, the movie, Spider-Man the movie game, and you play Spider-Man 2, it's pretty cool, but it's pretty funny because this game has a lot of those same elements in it, and it's funny to think that this game came out, you know, before those other ones did, and that they were already thinking of those types of elements. This came out in 2001. Not sure when Spider-Man the movie, the second game came out, but, you know, it was a couple years anyway. So, it's complete, and it's in good shape. This one was one of those ones that was really kind of... pretty scratched up, and I took it over to Vintage Stock and actually had them rebuff it. So, I don't know if it was skipping. It may have, but I don't think it was. I just think it was really scratched up, and I wanted to clean it up for my collection. Here's another game, Armada. This is I think it's a space shooter. Don't quote me. Don't really remember playing it, but it's complete. I'm kind of showing you the ones that I have less interest in that I've picked up. And then, yeah, this has got a lot of surface scratching on it, too. It's got a Game Exchange sticker in it. I don't know that I bought this at Game Exchange, but maybe I did. I don't think I did. I think I got it at the thrift store. Next game is... Revolt. This is like a RC car racing. I thought it was going to be a little bit more like RC Pro-Am. Don't know why. It reminds me more of like just a straight racing game, which isn't bad. But it wasn't exactly what I thought, but it's a good game. It's not bad. It's definitely, if you like racers, I mean, it's a good quality title. Oh, here's a favorite of a lot of people, Crazy Taxi. This is one of the few all-star games I have. I think I only have like one or two of these. Most of them I have an original label. This one I think I got at the flea mart when I was walking around. I found it in somebody's booth, Crazy Taxi. I didn't have it, so I went ahead and picked it up. But I would still maybe like to get a black label or a white label copy down the road maybe. Don't really have a need to. Next game. I lost track a long time ago of how many games we had. Toy Commander. This is an awesome game. Toy Commander, I played quite a bit. I didn't beat it, but I played quite extensively, really. I had never played it, and when I played it on this system, I really thought it was pretty fun. Just being all these little toys and working through the environments of a, you know, kitchen or whatever, dining room, things like that. Pretty cool. This is a game that I basically got because of how unique the art on the cover was. And the disc and stuff was. It wasn't because I necessarily thought it was going to be a good game, but it turns out it's not bad. It's called Super Magnetic Neo, and I think the case art is really kick-ass. I don't know why, but I just really dug the case art. And the disc, it's complete. The disc is bright pink. And it's got a teddy bear in a noose on it. And I don't know why, but I thought that this looked really cool with the art. There's some more art underneath. So I picked it up, and it's fun. You use different magnetic things to navigate sections. I think you can make him jump really high or fly in certain areas and things based on the magnets and stuff. So it's pretty cool. Here's one I'm pretty sure a lot of people probably had if you were into the RPG genre. That would be Phantasy Star Online. And I picked this up, yeah, I missed the ability to really be able to play it online. But it's got a Sonic 2 trial, and it's got the Phantasy Star Online disc. And then this actually, I think there's some, like, serial number or something you have to have for it, if I recall correctly. I don't know. I don't remember. I think there's a special serial number or something. Oh, there it is. They put it on a sticker inside the case. There's a serial number and an access key that you need to, in order to even be able to play it. And they put it on the sticker on the inside. So I played some of this. I actually played quite a bit of this when I first got the system. Because I don't know. I just thought it was really unique and really cool. And I love the other Phantasy Star games. So I thought this was really awesome. Next game, I think I picked this up at the thrift store. Not sure I've played it. It's called Chef's Love Shack. And it's got authentic voices and stuff, multiplayer. It looks like mini games, things like that. I'm not really sure. Haven't played it. But I got it. Okay. Next game is, I think I talked about this a little bit ago, Rayman 2, The Great Escape. I thought this game had cool case art as well, and it's complete. Rayman's pretty fun. I thought this game was especially fun. I didn't beat it. I've only beat one game, and I'll tell you what it is when I get there. Spider-Man's probably the only other one that I came fairly close to beating. The rest of these, I didn't come anywhere near beating. But I've enjoyed them. I take that back. I beat some of these games because I had them for the PlayStation 1 and stuff, but that I rebought. But I will tell you that when I get to them. The next game is Spawn in the Demon's Hand. This is basically like a fighting game. It's a straight in the Blockbuster arcade game. Based on an arcade game. Up to four players can death style match or battle royale. This one of those games where if you play through kind of the story-esque mode, you unlock other characters. And it's basically a fighting game. I didn't know it was a fighting game when I bought it, but I actually enjoy it quite a bit. I'm happy with it. I was surprised because I didn't think that's what it was going to be, but that's what it is. This one, I don't really know. I know I got it at the pawn shop for $1. I don't really remember that much about it, but it's called Ooga Booga, and it looks like a, kind of a multiplayer. Kind of reminds me of, like, Crash Bandicoot or something, but it's complete. Disc isn't in bad shape. And some of these I don't really remember because I bought them, and they just kind of put them up. Okay, the next game. This game is fun. I didn't get very far, but I enjoyed it a lot. And this game kind of introduced me to the cel-shading style of video games that I found later more kind of appealing and kind of cool. And that would be Jet Grind Radio. The cel-shading style is just really awesome. And like I said, I didn't get super far on this, but it was definitely worth whatever I paid for it to get Jet Grind Radio, and it's in good shape, and it's complete. I keep kind of picking through these because I keep changing the order I want to do stuff. The next one is, I remember I bought this one off of eBay I won it off somebody's bid because I couldn't find it anywhere and I really wanted to play it. And I know they had it for the Nintendo 64, but I wanted it for the Dreamcast. And that's a South Park Rally. This game is basically like Mario Kart with South Park people. I mean, that's pretty much what it is. And it's got the original voices and stuff. This game kicks ass. Kick ass! This game is awesome. I love it because if you like Mario Kart style racers and you like South Park, this is it. This is the one. And I'd say the Dreamcast version, because I prefer the Dreamcast controller over the Nintendo 64 controller, and I think the graphics may be a little better on this. I don't want to say they are because I don't know, but, you know, whatever. I'll say they are. Screw it. I'll take a stand. Okay. All right. We're getting down to some other stuff here. Let's go ahead and show the games I have some multiples of. This game is the other one that inspired me to pick up the console. That would be Sonic Arcade. Or not Sonic Arcade. Sonic Adventure. Two-disc set. I can tell this is the one that I got from the pawn shop because the case is more dirty. And this one doesn't always want to start in my system for some reason, or any of the systems. And it's not because it's scratched, because it's really not scratched that much. Okay. Two copies. I couldn't tell you which one's which, but I know that I paid through the ass at vintage stock for my copy, and then I got one for free. From Ben, so we have Sonic Adventure 2. I think I paid close to $20 for this at Bennett Stock, and I got a free copy. So I don't know. I'm gonna hold on to both of them. And the last game that I have two copies of is because I found this one out in the wild first, and then I bought the joystick to play it. And it came with a copy. So, the game is Sega Bass Fishing. And this is a copy I found originally out and about. And it's an All-Star. This is the other All-Star game that I have. Other than the Crazy Taxi and this one, all of them are not the orange end ones. But it's complete. And this disc says All-Stars on it. This one... The only difference is it does not say All-Stars on it. But the reason I bought the second copy is because of this. And I got the Sega Dreamcast fishing controller. So I think I got the fishing controller and the game for $10. And I think I got it out at the Lee Summit vintage stock. And so I couldn't pass it up because I didn't have the controller. And I was like, well, I want to have the fishing controller for the fishing game. So went ahead and picked it up. And it came with the game. So those are the three games I have doubles of. The rest is smooth sailing here, folks. Let's see. Next game we picked up. I'm a big fan of this particular title, but not necessarily of this game. That would be Prince of Persia, Arabian Nights. This one is the first, like, 3D-esque Prince of Persia game that I've come across. And it's hard as hell to play. The camera angle's always getting stuck in weird positions. And it's just, it's hard to really get a good feel on the game. But it is complete. And it's Prince of Persia. Sands of Time is probably the best one. But Prince of Persia, let's see here. I'm going to show the couple of fighting games that I have. I had a second copy of this, but I think I traded it to somebody. I have Soul Calibur for the Dreamcast. Why am I drawing a blank here, folks? And it's complete. This has a vintage stock sticker on the back of it for $14.99. I'm almost positive I did not pay that. I think it was shrink-wrapped and had a different price sticker on it. Because I know I don't think I would have paid $15 for Soul Calibur. And I know I found another copy of it at the thrift store for a couple bucks. So I hope I didn't pay 15 for it. This one I know I did pay like 30 for, and it's all right. I don't mind paying the 30 for it, but for some reason these particularly the fighting games for the Dreamcast, especially at vintage stock, are still pricey. They've come down slightly in price in the last couple of years, and I think it's because they haven't really moved that stock out of their store, so they've been sitting on it, so they're like, well, let's reduce the price to get it moving. So I think some of these fighting games have come down from like $50 to around $25 or $30, and I'm thinking about picking up a couple. But this second one I have is Street Fighter 3 Double Impact. I want to get Third Strike, but they wanted like $40 or $50 for Third Strike when I bought Double Impact, which was only like $30. I think they wanted $50 for Third Strike, and I'm not a huge fighting game fan, but you know, I do love to play a Street Fighter game, and Double Impact is pretty awesome. It's got both the new generation and Second Impact on it, so it's got two different games on it actually. So this is pretty awesome. I am going to get Third Strike, and I would like to get the Marvel vs. Capcom 1 and 2. They're still like $30 at the vintage stocks as well. And I know that one of them has Marvel vs. Capcom 2. I think it's a Blue String Store for $30 complete, but I just can't bring myself to buy it yet. The final fighting game I have is Mortal Kombat Gold. It is complete. And it's in good shape. I like Mortal Kombat as well, and this one was the Mortal Kombat game that was released on the Dreamcast. All-time favorite characters return to defend the Earth from Shinnok and blah, 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 blah. Basically, it's Mortal Kombat. The Dreamcast, so. Okay, we're getting down to it, folks. Getting close. This video is running long, long, long. Next game, Soul Reaver. Soul Reaver is awesome. I love this game. I got it for the PS1 originally, but I had to rebuy it for the Dreamcast because what we did, I went up to the game exchange and was up there, and they allowed me to put the PlayStation 1 up and the Dreamcast one up side by side on their test screens and see which one looked better. And, you know, the pixel count and things. And the Dreamcast had the PlayStation 1 ass. You know, it handed the PlayStation 1's ass to it. So I had to get it. And so I went and picked up Soul Reaver. The next game we have here is Zombie Revenge. This is kind of a classic gun-style game, arcade-style gun game. And it's pretty cool. It's kind of like zombies and monsters, and I think you can play three different characters. I dropped the instruction book. Hold on, folks. This is gonna run forever. I hope you got a good 45 minutes to dedicate to this. If you do, you do. If you don't, you don't. I understand. Next game I picked up, I ordered this brand new, still in the shrink wrap, because I heard that it was a cult classic for the system and I had to check it out. I did stick it in, I remember, but I don't remember that much about it. I picked up the game Illbleed for the Dreamcast, and it is complete because I bought it brand new. The disc is brand new, not any nicks or scratches on it at all. Because I think I only stuck it in the system one time to check it out and watch the intro and things like that. We're getting down to it. Next game, Hail to the King, baby. Hail to the King. Evil Dead. This is another one of those that I had on the PlayStation 1, but the graphics just look like an upgrade on the Dreamcast. And the PlayStation 1 version is two discs, and this one's all on one disc. So I picked it up, and I love Evil Dead, so... Dino Crisis is the next game. I also have this on the PS1. Decided to go ahead and pick it up on the Dreamcast. basically the same reasoning. The graphics are an upgrade, and I've never beaten Dino Crisis. This game's too hard for me to beat. I have beaten Dino Crisis 2. I have not beaten Dino Crisis 1. Now we're getting into some territory. Oh, yeah, I beat Soul Reaver on the PlayStation. I've never beat it on the Dreamcast. Now we're getting into some territory of some games that I have beat. And we'll work through these here. But I beat them on the PlayStation 1. I picked up Resident Evil 2 on the Dreamcast. It's complete. Disc 2. This one is still on two discs, but it's pretty awesome. There are some differences between this version and the other one as far as graphics and stuff go, but there's not a lot of difference. And another Resident Evil, I picked up Resident Evil 3 Nemesis. This game, from what I remember at the beginning, it seemed like you had a lot more costume choices and stuff with the character just right off the bat. And it seemed like it was basically the same game, but it just seemed like the same thing applied. It just had better graphics all around. They were an upgrade and couldn't pass it up. So I went and picked up Nemesis. You didn't know I had this many games, did you? The final one, the Resident Evils that I went and picked up, excuse me, I went and picked up Resident Evil Code Veronica. Now, I had this for the PS2. It's actually the game I bought when I bought my PS2. It was the first game I bought and played. And I came close to beating it on the PS2, but I never did. And then I decided to buy the original on the Dreamcast because this was what it was originally released on. So I bought it on the original system, and I played through some of it, but I didn't actually beat it. Okay. Now we're down to my kind of bigger collection that was saved, the game I have beat for last. The next game I picked up, this case is a little worked. This is the one I'm missing the instructions for, but I picked up a while back Grandia 2. And this is kind of a role-playing-esque game. It's got one disc there. I think it's supposed to have the instruction booklet there. And then it's got a... I think it's a soundtrack right there. So, we're missing the instruction booklet, which is kind of a bummer. Might, you know, look into rebuying it someday or something. I'm not too picky. I need a drink. I'm drying out. We got to hurry here. We got basically 10 minutes left, and it's going to be 45 minutes on this sucker. Big ups to anybody that actually sits through all three parts. Gold Star. I haven't given out Gold Stars in a while, but you get Gold Star if you sat through all three parts, so... let's get rolling. I got four games left. The next one is Alone in the Dark. Now, I don't remember how good this is. I remember sticking it in. It is complete. The directions. Got this at Vintage Stock, I know. I think I paid $12 to $15 for it. Don't know. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool case art there. Two discs and complete. I wonder if you all can guess what the last two are. I know you saw the big wide shot, but let's go ahead and show them. I picked up this at Game Exchange. I was surprised they had this game. This one was a little bit hard to find. I couldn't find a copy of it online for sale, actually. This came up at Game Exchange. I picked up D2. Now, D1, I think, is a little bit harder to find. I have it in the long box, and it seems like when I see it at places, it's pretty expensive, and I don't really know why. Because, I mean, it was a good game, but it wasn't like, I didn't feel that it was this, you know, worth that much money, the amount of money that they're asking for it nowadays. And I think it's like in the $30 range, but This game is four discs. It's complete. Here's the first two discs. This game reminded me more kind of a Resident Evil style versus the other one, which felt more like a Myst or something style game. Here's the other two discs. This one, I think you are running around in the snow or something after a plane crash, or I don't really remember right off the bat, but here's the instruction book. It was complete. I think I might have paid $20 for this, but I was happy, and I still am happy with it. Remote northern region of Canadian mountains, left stranded in the snowy landscape. Yeah, so I don't know. I don't really remember. I didn't get very far into it, but I would like to revisit that game and finish it. Final two games here, folks. The first one that we're going to show you is one of the ones that everybody talks about on this system. I have barely played it. It's Shenmue, and it is a black label copy, and it's complete. I did get this at Game Exchange. The instructions. First two discs. And they're in great shape. Excuse me. And then we have disc three. And the Shenmue Passport disc. Not sure what that is. And then we have the Passport instruction book. Not really sure what this is. But it is complete. So I think this is another one that I paid, you know, $15-$20 for. But I got it at Game Exchange. It was complete. And I was happy to find it. So went and picked it up. This is the only game for the Dreamcast that I have beaten. And I want to get a copy of this in the actual box, because I do have the pieces, but I want to get one of the original box versions. And that would be the game, folks, Seaman. Now, if you've never played this, it's not really a game. I don't know how to describe it. I mean, it is a game, but you basically have this aquarium tank. And you have to do certain things in order to facilitate these creatures to start growing. But as they're growing and developing, it basically looks like a fish or a kind of tadpole fish thing with legs. And it has a human face on it. And that's basically what it is. But you talk to it through this microphone. And you ask it questions and things, and it will answer back. Sometimes it doesn't understand what you're saying. It does know by the date and time on the system, you know, when holidays are and things like that. So it's funny to listen to it tell you certain things and ask you certain things. But eventually, once you go through the whole deal, you will eventually set it free into the wild. And when you do that, the game's basically over. I did that, so I did finish one Dreamcast game, and that would be Seaman. Leonard Nimoy does the narration on this, which is pretty funny, and it was well worth my time. You do have to mind it every day, because you got to keep the tank temperature turned up and the aeration turned up, and if you don't, then it will cause the creature to die. So you do have to check the game every couple of days, or every day, and make sure that your tank is adjusted properly, because it will, even when it's off, degrade. So I would like to get a box copy of this. So this is my final game, and that's basically it, folks. I was gonna try to squeeze a little more in here, but battery's flashing, so I'm probably about to die. I was gonna show you this. I have a Dreamcast controller in box. It is the red controller. This is brand new. I bought it at the Game or Vintage Stock for like $8, and it's still in the box. It's brand new. And this keyboard is also brand new. I got it at the Lee Summit Vintage Stock, and I think I paid $10 for it, and it's brand new. That's the second gen boxes. The controller is the first gen box. And then that's about it. So that was my Dreamcast collection. Hope y'all dug it. I'm going to sign off because I'm afraid this is going to end at any second. Hope y'all enjoyed that or saw some games that maybe you want to check out. Or if you guys have any questions about any of those games you want me to answer in comments and stuff, I will. So just let me know. So I'm going to sign off. There's a few things that I still want. I want a yellow Dreamcast controller with the VMU that's yellow to go with it. I want to get Typing of the Dead for my keyboard. And like I said, the Lara Croft, and there's a couple other games that I still want. Third Strike, Marvel vs. Capcom 2, and maybe, I don't know, just there's a couple games. But that's basically it. So that was my Dreamcast collection, and see you next video, folks. Gold Star.
Is this not why you are here?